Mordecai, a snipe-bear who lost his beloved Bloodwing at the hands of Jack. Torg. Mud explosion, then men. Yeah. Ellie, a master mechanic. Yee-haw! And finally, Lilith, a siren gifted with incredible powers. However, she was not the only siren. Jack's daughter, Angel, used her powers to manipulate and betray the Vault Hunters. Though she turned on her father in the end, the damage was done. Jack was defeated, but at a heavy cost. Roland didn't live to see the victory his friends had earned. Sometimes a hero's reward is little more than a gunshot to the back at the hands of a coward. The ones Roland left behind still had much to do, but one little girl had some ideas for a story of her own. Once upon a time, the Vault Hunters played a game.
The world is on the brink of going boom boom. This is our most desperate hour. Unless we make a stand here and now, we gonna die. Now. Roll for initiative!
What's initiative?
It says which order we attack in.
I punched the initiative.
What's going on? I wasn't paying attention.
Tina, why don't you start over?
Welcome, fine ladies, to your first session of the most coolest game in the world, Bunkers and Badasses! As your Bunker Master, I will be spinning today's tale of fantasy and...
Wait, why the hell are we playing this kid's game?
Oh, you know, maybe because... Shut the hell up, Morty!
Tina! She's right, though. Shut up.
Well, our vault-hunting buddies beat the slam-a-jamma out of that Hyperion informant downstairs, I thought we could play a game. Now, pick your characters. You got the Necromancer, the Commando, the Siren...
Siren. Dibs. My Siren's name is Brick, and she is the prettiest.
Tina, why don't we just start now and figure that out later?
Come on, girl. You know we gotta wait for Roland before we start.
Tina, Roland's... You know Roland's not coming, right? He's not here anymore.
Probably running late or something. We'll just start now. So, like I said, roll for initiative, sucker! You arrive at the docks of Flame Rock Refuge. This place used to be really nice, until the handsome sorcerer messed everything up.
I say we head toward the town to investigate.
Lovely day in Flame Rock Refuge. A far cry from-
Wait, didn't you just say the sorcerer messed up the town? Why would things be lovely?
What I meant to say is, it's eternal night, and you hear spooky music, And the whole area kind of smells like butts and dead people.
Kind of smells like butts and dead people.
Suddenly you're attacked by a horde of skellymans! They start shooting at you! You get close to the entrance to Flame Rock Refuge, but suddenly... the handsome sorcerer's pet dragon appears! Surprise attack!
Ho ho, I wanna smack it.
You try to attack the dragon! your attacks do nothing! The dragon attacks and... Critical hit!
Great. Are we done now?
Tina, you can't start your campaign with a boss fight. Players can't win.
Touche. Okay, everybody back up!
I wanted to kill something.
Okay, how about a new boss? He's a skeleton. And his name is... Mr. Bony Pants Guy?
I am Mr. Bony Pants Guy!
Does that work?
This pleases me.
Right, the road to Flame Rock Refuge is open. You should go there. Go, go, go.
Ooh, you've got a grenade mod. Those change the way your grenades behave. If you find the right mod, you can throw grenades that home in on targets or spew flame or split into a bazillion tiny grenades. They're badass.
Thank you. I am the great Spatula Khan, destroyer of men and the pleaser of the taste buds. I was greatest chef on Pandora until the weenie emperor rose to power.
Thank you. Thank you.
Decisions.
You've entered the town of Flame Rock Refuge. In the distance, you see the town's scouting blimps, always alert in case of battles and stuff. What you gonna do now?
Stop playing this game?
Let's talk to some townfolk.
A grand idea.